we are going to discuss about the line spectra of hydrogen atom. It has been shown that the energy of outer orbit is greater than the energy of inner ones. When the hydrogen atom is subjected to external energy, the electron jumps from lower energy state to a higher energy state. That is, the hydrogen atom is excited. The excited state is not stable, hence the electron returns to its ground state in about 10⁻⁸ seconds. The excess of energy is now radiated in the form of different wavelengths. The different wavelengths constitute spectral series which are characteristics of atom emitting them. The wavelength of the different members of the series can be found from the following relation: nu equals to 1 by lambda equals to r into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. This relation explains the complete spectrum of hydrogen. A detailed account of important radiations are below. A. First one, Lyman series. This series consists of all wavelengths which are emitted when an electron jumps from an outer orbit to its first orbit. That is, the electronic jumps from K orbit gives rise to Lyman series. Here, n1 equals to 1 and n2 equals to 2, 3, so on up to infinity. The wavelengths of different members of Lyman series are: first member, in this case n1 equals to 1 and n2 equals to 2. Substituting, we get lambda equals to 1216 angstrom units. The second member is in this case n1 equals to 1 and n2 equals to 3, and substitute we get lambda equals to 1026 angstrom units. Similarly, the limiting member, in this case n1 equals to 1 and n2 equals to infinity, we get lambda equals to 912 angstrom units. This series of wavelengths lies in ultraviolet region. Second one is Bama series. This series consists of all wavelengths which are emitted when an electron jumps from an outer orbit to the second orbit. That is, the electronic jumps from L orbit gives rise to Balmer series. Here, n1 equals to 2 and n2 equals to 3, 4, 5, so on up to infinity. The wavelengths of different members of Balmer series are: first member, in this case n1 equals to 2 and n2 equals to 3. Therefore, the lambda will be 6563 angstrom units. Second member is n1 equals to 2, n2 equals to 4. Therefore, we get lambda equals to 4861 angstrom units. The limiting member n1 equals to 2 and n2 is infinity. Therefore, we get lambda equals to 3646 angstrom units. The series lies in visible and near ultraviolet region. Third one is fashion series. This series consists of all wavelengths which are emitted when an electron jumps from an outer orbit to the third orbit. That is, the electron jumps from to M orbit gives rise to fashion series. N1 equals to 3 and N2 equals to 4, 5, 6, so on up to infinity. The different wavelengths of this series can be obtained. We get lambda equals to r into 1 by 3 square minus 1 by n2 square, where n2 is 4, 5, 6, so on up to infinity. The first member, the wavelength is 18,750 angstrom units. This series lies in infrared region. Fourth one is bracket series. This series consists of all wavelengths which are emitted when an electron jumps from an outer orbit to the fourth orbit. That is, the electron jumps to N orbit gives rise to bracket series. N1 equals to 4 and N2 equals to 5, 6, 7, so on up to infinity. Therefore, the lambda region will lies in the infrared region of the spectrum. Fifth one is fun series. This series consists of all wavelengths which are emitted when an electron jumps from an outer orbit to the fifth orbit. That is, the electron jumps to O orbit gives rise to bracket series. Here n1 equals to 5 and n2 equals to 6, 7, 8, so on up to infinity. The different wavelengths of the series can be obtained, and this series will be lies in infrared region. The tabulated results will be shown like this. Lyman series observed will be Lyman series, Baumol series, Paschen series, bracket series, Fan series. Value of n1 will be 1, 2, 3, so 4, 5. Value of n2 will be 2, 3, 4, so infinity. 3, 4, 5, so on up to infinity. 4, 5, 6, so on up to infinity. 5, 6, 7, so on up to infinity. 6, 7, 8, so on up to infinity. Position of the spectrum will be ultraviolet, visible, infrared, infrared, infrared regions. Next is Rydberg's formula. After a detailed study of spectral series of different elements, Rydberg in 1889 arrived at the following equation. 1 by lambda it will be equals to nu equals to r into 1 by m square minus 1 by n square. This is known as Rydberg formula. Here r will be known as Rydberg constant, and m and n are integers with n greater than m. Next is explanation of atomic spectra. First one is orbit diagram. According to the general expression of radii of different orbits, few stationary orbits are drawn in the figure. The orbit marked n1 will be equals to 1 is called the ground and represents the stationary state of unexcited atom. The orbits corresponds to n1 equals to 1, 2, 3, so on, etc., RK, LM, etc., shells. Suppose by some process such as a thermal agitation or impact of particles such as photon, electron, proton, etc., the revolving electron in hydrogen atom is removed from the ground state to some orbit of higher energy, n2 will be equals to 4. Now the revolving electron of the atom possesses the more energy than normal state and is less stable. The electron now returns to the ground state in 10⁻⁸ seconds, either in one step or in intermediate steps. Example, it jumps from n equals to 4 to n equals to 1 in one step, or alternatively 4 to 2 or 2 to 1, or 4 to 3, 3 to 1, or 4 to 3, 3 to 2, 3, 2 to 1. In each step, the electron radiates the energy difference of the two states in the form of radiations whose frequency is given by n into E minus E n1 equals to h nu. In this way, the different members of the series are obtained. One atom at any instance can emit only one frequency nu, but since there are always several atoms in reasonable quantity of hydrogen, they emit different frequencies and the result is a series of lines. Here, it should be remembered that the number of atoms involved is so large that for an observer, the lines appear to be produced continuously. Second one is energy level diagram. Above we have explained the different spectral lines on the basis of geometrical concepts of orbit. A much more important concept than above is in terms of energy level diagram. In this diagram, discrete energy state to the atom are represented by horizontal lines and transition of atom from one state to other state, giving rise to spectral line. Is shown by a vertical line joining the states involved. Transitions from higher levels to ground level gives rise to Lyman series. The other series are also indicated in the diagram. Thus, the line emission spectrum of hydrogen atom is completely and correctly represented by Bohr's theory. Rydberg combination principle. It is observed that if somehow an electron is excited to some orbit, say fourth orbit, it can return to its normal state. First, directly from fourth to first state, or in three steps, 4 to 3, 3 to 2, and 2 to 1. We know that total energy remains the same. Therefore, the sum of frequencies of last three lines will be equal to the frequency of third line of Lyman series. It is observed that many combinations exist between the observed frequencies of various lines radiated from the same parent atom.
New L1 will be frequency of first line of Lyman series. New L2 will be frequency of second line of Lyman series. New B1 will be frequency of first line of Balmer series. It is observed that new L1 plus new B1 equals to new L2. This is known as Ritz-Hilbert combination principle. This relation can be expressed in terms of wave numbers as new L1 plus new B1 equals to new L2. The principle is valid only for frequency and wave numbers only and not for wavelengths. Next is Bohr's correspondence principle. The orbital frequency of an electron revolving in nth stationary orbit is given by nu equals to 1 by n cube into m e power 4 by 4 epsilon naught square h cube. According to electromagnetic theory, an electron moving in a circular orbit with frequency nu should radiate electromagnetic energy in the form of electromagnetic waves of frequency nu. Consider Bohr's atomic model. An electron jumping from stationary orbit n to lower energy stationary orbit m have a frequency of radiation nu equals to m e power 4 by epsilon naught square h cube into 1 by m square minus 1 by n square. Therefore, we get nu orbital divided by nu Bohr equals to 2 by n cube into m square n square by n plus m into m minus m. When m is a very large, m equals to n minus 1, then nu orbital divided by nu Bohr equals to approximately equals to 1. This expression shows that for higher quantum number, the frequency of radiation emitted by electronic transitions term is approximately the same as the frequency of radiation as per classical electrodynamics. Therefore, for large quantum numbers, the quantum theory arrives at the same results as arrived by classical theory in physics. This statement of Bohr is known as Bohr's correspondence principle. Limitations of Bohr's theory. Bohr's theory was able to explain successfully a number of experimental observed facts and has correctly predicted the spectral lines of neutral hydrogen atom and signally the ionized helium atom, etc. In terms of only principal quantum number, the theory fails to explain the following facts. First one, the theory could not account the spectra of atoms more complex than hydrogen. Second one, the theory does not give any information regarding the distribution and arrangement of electrons in atom. Third one, it does not explain the experimentally observed variations in intensity of the spectral lines of an element. Fourth one, this theory cannot be used to calculate about transitions from one level to another, such as the rate at which they occur or selection rules which apply to them. Fifth one, this theory fails to further accounting the fine structure of spectral line. Actually, it was found that when spectral lines emitted by an atom are examined, each line is composed of several lines closely packed together. Bohr's theory does not throw any light on it. Sixth one, this theory cannot be used for the quantitative explanation of chemical bonding. Last one is, the theory fails to give a correct result when an electric or magnetic field is applied to the atom. It is found that when electric or magnetic field to the atom, each spectral line splits into several lines. The former effect is called as Stark effect, while later Zeeman effect.